Welcome to Doggo.jl, your home for wholesome Julia tutorials. I started recording this series a few months ago. Since then, a new version of Julia has been released. There are several different ways to update Julia, but in this video, I'm going to show you one of the ways to update to the latest version of Julia. I'm currently using Julia version 1.9.3. But as of this recording, the current stable release is version 1.9.4, according to the download page of Julia's official website. The version number contains three numbers separated by a decimal point. If the third number changes, that indicates a patch release, or a relatively small change. With a patch, it's generally not necessary to update versions. But if the middle number changes, that indicates a minor release. With a minor update, it's generally recommended to update versions. If the first number changes, that indicates a major breaking release. With Julia, this first number took roughly 10 years to change from version 0 to version 1, so a major version release is a pretty rare event. Even though it's not required, I'm going to update my version of Julia to the latest version so you can see the workflow for updating Julia. To update Julia manually, there are only two steps. 1. Uninstall Julia. And then, 2. Reinstall Julia. I'm using Windows, so to uninstall Julia, I use the Windows Apps Manager, which you can find under Windows, Settings, Apps, Installed Apps. In the search bar, search for Julia. And uninstall the version of Julia that you're currently using. In my case, it's Julia version 1.9.3. Uninstalling will remove this Julia version from my hard drive and remove it from my environment path. It will also remove the shortcut icon for the REPL from my desktop. After it's done uninstalling, you can reinstall Julia just like you did when you first installed it by going to the download page at Julia's official website. Since you've seen this workflow before, I'm going to go through this part a little quicker. For Julia version 1.9.4, I'm downloading the Windows 64-bit installer executable file onto my desktop. Then, I'm executing the installer by double-clicking it. During the installation process, I'm checking the box to add Julia to path. And that's it! After the installation is complete, you should see a new shortcut icon for the Julia REPL using version 1.9.4. You can see the version number here in the REPL. Any package that you installed previously using version 1.9 should still be there. You can see a list of the current packages by typing in status in the package manager. In my case, the Pluto package that was used in a previous chapter is still here after updating to the latest version of Julia. The Julia version used in VS Code will update automatically the next time you open VS Code. I'm using the hello.jl file from Chapter 6 as a test. and opening up the Julia REPL by using Alt-J, then Alt-O. You can see the Julia version number here in the REPL tab. The other way to check the version number is to use the version info function in the REPL. In the editor, I'm using Shift-Enter to evaluate this line of code. If you see Hello World in the REPL, then congratulations! You have successfully updated to the latest version of Julia. Woohoo! So that's one way to update to the latest version of Julia. In the next chapter, you'll learn where to find help when using Julia.